seat.
Thank you, sir.
Right now you're working?
In India also.
Where?
Sir, Faridabad, in R&D center.
R&D center?
Yes, sir.
So you are in research and development?
Yes, sir, in procurement team.
In?
Procurement of services team.
Procurement of?
Services.
Services. Okay. So you are already drawing a hefty amount per month. It's 1,60,000.
Yes, sir.
But if you join UPS, IAS exam, in IAS, then your salary will not be protected.
Yes, sir. I am aware about that.
How much loss it will be?
So around 70,000 something.
So you are comfortable with that?
Yes, sir. No.
Why? How?
Sir, since childhood, I have dream regarding civil services. And due to some family issues, some family responsibilities and some different responsibilities, I joined ISL and I could not clear civil servant service exam in right time. So right now, I am.
So you have already appeared for how many times?
So this is my fifth
attempt.
Yes, sir.
And you have appeared for interview earlier?
No, sir.
This is the first interview.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you are a mechanical engineering?
Yes, sir.
Engineer?
Yes, sir.
So don't you think that there are other options, better options, already one of the which you already exercising? So you said that it is your dream to be a civil servant. What prompts that?
Sir, actually, yes, no doubt ki ISL has provided me an opportunity to learn about hierarchy, neutrality, interpersonal competence and also technical skills. But if I remain in ISL, then it is only provide me opportunity to work in corporate sector. But as a civil servant, I can work in corporate sector, corporate governance also, in social governance also, in economic governance also, even in cultural governance also. So it provides me an opportunity to work as a social transformer of India as a civil servant.
Social transformer?
Social economic transformer, sorry, sir.
Hmm?
Social economic transformer.
Okay, tell us about how you will go about transforming the society.
Sir, right now our society is facing lot of issues regarding poverty and like child development, nutrition, agriculture issues. So
these are economic issues.
Socio-economic issues. Sir. Both have social and economic issues.
Okay, poverty.
Agriculture, sir.
Mm-hmm.
And and lot of and other issues.
What other issues? What social issues? These are both economic issues. Poverty as well as agriculture.
Sir, vulnerable sections are facing like lot of issues like atrocities and all.
Atrocities and others.
And sir, also they are marginalization due to lack of livelihood concerns like manual scavenging.
Okay. Which law is there to prevent this manual scavenging?
Sir, Manual Scavenging Act, Prevention Act, I think 2002.
So what is the status right now?
So right now, as per one NGO's report, that around this year, around 109 people are died in manual scavenging. So it is a big challenge.
Are you sure it's 109?
Sir, this year.
This year. Which is that NGO? Who runs that NGO?
Sir, actually I read in...
There is a personality who got that Magsaysay Award.
Yes, sir. Wilson. Mr. Wilson.
Wilson?
Yes, sir.
Bejwada.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So you are from Rajasthan. What are the main problems faced by Rajasthan in socio-economic aspects?
Socio-economic aspect. Right,
yes.
Now, sir, the news are regarding mob lynching, atrocities. So this issues are raising. It shows that yes, we are facing a lot of tensions in our
atrocities
on Dalits and
okay.
Mob lynching kind of issues are reporting. So these kind of.
So what are the root causes of it? Is it because of failure of the state machinery? Have we failed in establishing rule of law? Or is it because of some other deep-rooted causes?
Sir, have different concerns. First of all, I think, sir, yes, state machineries are have some kind of lackness due to some, might be some due to manpower issues, might be due to prejudice. It's create issues like these kind of issues are not taking in proper sense. And also, I think, sir, right now the societies are, so every sector, every caste, region, religion are becoming more assertiveness due to political empowerment. It creates a lot of tensions, which might be in future it will improve. But right now, due to some kind of assertiveness in, from every part of...
So suppose you are a district magistrate, what you will do in this field to restore the social harmony in this district?
Sir, first of all, it is better to to involve all stakeholders regarding why these kind of issues are becoming majorly happening in recently. Like one DM in Alwar district faced lot of success regarding the same. That he provided a platform for harmony based committee that the people are discuss about issues like what we are facing issues from other community, they can solve this by, and also another.
Okay, sir, what is the main issue in southern Rajasthan districts? Are you aware about this?
Yes, sir. Southern Rajasthan, sir, majorly the tribal states like Dungarwara is mostly 99% people are tribals. Hmm. They are facing issues like migration due to lack of livelihood.
Is it migration or child trade?
Yes, sir. Child trade is also there. Child trade is also, and Saharia tribe is also facing a lot of issues due to exploitation by moneyland by other peoples. So these kind of issues are in South Rajasthan is there. So we have to take lot of actions. But right now, Rajasthan government is taking lot of actions.
Right. Your father is a local audit officer. Yes, he is, sir, working in government of Rajasthan.
No, sir, in defense sector.
In defense sector.
Yes, sir.
Which service?
Sir, IDS.
Indian Defense.
Account service.
Account service. Sir. IDAS.
IDS. Sir.
Okay. Okay.
And.
Yes, sir.
Since your father is in the defense service, you must have got a chance to be posted all over the country. Where all have you been posted to?
My father spent a lot of time in Rajasthan also.
Okay.
In, majorly. And right now he is posting in Bareilly.
So are you aware ki how many areas this army divided to and commands?
Sir,
my father in defense account service.
Sir, actually, I spent lot of time in my rural my village.
You're not staying with your father?
No, sir. I didn't spend time with my father. Didn't live with my father in my schooling time.
Okay. Then, into how many, for the purpose of defense of India, into how many commands the country is divided into?
I think 5. I'm not sure, sir.
There are 3 services.
Okay.
And your father is working only for army or
yes,
for
sir,
defense
for
or
army.
For air force also?
Only for army.
Only for the army. Is he in the Indian defense account service or some other?
Yes, sir, defense account service.
The group A service?
No, group, not group A service, sir. He's selected from SSC.
Okay. So, for the purpose of defense of this country, Navy has got a command structure, Air Force has got a command structure, and Army also has got a command structure. Are you aware of them?
Sir, I heard about that, but I'm not sure.
This is your
Navy command is, I'm heard in newspaper, but Army, I'm not sure.
Navy command, how many areas it is divided into?
Sir, I think 3.
3. Where is the location?
Sir, Eastern Command in Vizag, I think,
mm-hmm.
and in Western Command, and I think, I'm not sure, sir.
Okay. Recently, there has been a post which has been created, the CDS.
Yes, sir.
So, why do you think it was necessary?
Sir, actually, a lot of committees like Shaktavar Committee and Chandra Committee has recommended regarding that all three services are not getting proper procedure frameworks regarding coordination, regarding a lot of issues of overlapping of procurements. All these kind of issues are so government on recommendation of that committees, government has created this post because to increase integration in policy governance and also to reduce overlappings.
So what are the security concerns of India?
So right now, both conventional and as well as new kind of issues are generating. Like in conventional, that we are facing same problem. Like our neighborhood is creating lot of concerns regarding terrorism, land dispute issues, and also in new front we are facing challenges like cyber security. Right now, as per one report, I'm not sure about that report. The name of that report, but around I think 121 government sites has been hacked in last year. So it is a big challenge regarding this. And also drug trafficking, human trafficking, these kind of concerns are also facing a lot of.
So you are a mechanical engineer by profession, you've done your BTEC in mechanical
yes,
engineering,
sir.
And what is the future of this petrol engine in India?
So right now there is a lot of debate is going on that internal combustion engine can be gone, can be vanished, because China has made a statement like by 2030 they will finish internal combustion engine. But as per different reports that till 2040 or 2045 the oil sectors in India can't remove, because we do not develop so much energy resources like in renewable energy or and other sectors. So definitely internal combustion will remain till 2045. After that might be any new technology will come. And
so what is the alternate to internal combustion engine?
So right now electrical vehicles are there. And
Mr. What about hydrogen?
Hydrogen is also the HCNG. Fuel cell technology, and also Indian Oil has also provided HCNG, hydrogen CNG. Blending of 18% of hydrogen in CNG to improve the reduce the soot particles and improve the calorific value of CNG, and also reduce the import bill of our. It is in going on right now. Supreme Court has given a very good positive attitude towards our this technology, and right now we are using.
So where do you see the future of India as far as car industry is concerned?
Car industry is.
What route do you think India would be taking?
Sir, I'm not getting it.
BS6, basically
yes.
BS6 is the present, and they want to move towards 40% of the energy requirement are going to be met by non-conventional methods.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, with regard to the automobile sector, what is the future? Do you think it will go through the electrical way, the hybrid way, or it will go the...
Sir, first of all, it is right now we do not have any prompt, good technology to reduce the petrol, diesel. Right now, like ISL is investing in HCNG, because it is very difficult to remove oil sector in coming future, like up to 2030. But yes, electrical vehicles are in market right now. The Kia.
What is the main reason why this dependence on oil cannot be abolished or eliminated?
So right now, like electrical vehicles, we are talking.
No, so there must be some impediment in introduction of electrical vehicles. What are those?
So right now, like lithium import. If you want to making a battery, we need a lithium. Lithium is a very rare element. So if we import this, we definitely the same problem is that the import bill will rise. So right now, like in ISL, we are doing research on metal air batteries. We can remove the metal cathodes and again recharge it, and then again air convert metal into metal oxide, and it generate electricity. Right now we are doing that, but right now it is in trial basis, so it is difficult to remove.
So what portion of energy needs are met by oil, or how much is it met by domestically?
Sir, you are talking about, sir, energy or oil sector?
Oil sector.
Sir, in we process around 249 millimetric ton per year, and from that 35 millimetric ton is imported. Is produced domestically.
What percentage is that of the total requirement?
Sir, I think 7%.
7%. And which is which are the countries from which we import our oil?
Sir, we import from around 17 to 18 countries, and right now we import around 180 types of crude oils from different part of the world, like Venezuela, Nigeria, Dubai, and Saudi Arabia, and Iran is a major chunk. And also,
are you still importing from Iran?
No, sir. Till April, we have that.
Till April.
By card, sir.
अप्रैल तक हम कौन से साल की बात कर रहे हैं
सर? अप्रैल 2000 नो सॉरी सर, इट्स अ जून 2000 सॉरी सर।
सो आई थिंक दैट्स ऑल, थैंक यू।
ओके,
उमेश जी,
व्हाट इज द मोस्ट न्यूमरस, आई मस्ट हैव गॉन थ्रू द सेंसस फिगर्स, एंड इन द सेंसस फिगर दे डू मेंशन कि व्हिच इज द मोस्ट न्यूमरस ट्राइब न्यूमेरिकली।
Numerous tribe.
Yeah, they are out number
one. Which is the largest tribe population largest wise?
7.5% is the total population of Shuri tribe in this country.
8%. Sure.
Around 8% now. 8.1. The population has increased. So, which is the most numerous tribe? If you put them in, say, a descending order, which is the most numerous tribe? And what is the representation? And if it is not in proportion to their population, then how can you ensure that?
Sir, we need.
But are you aware of the population? If you put them in descending or descending order, which is the most numerous? Top three tribes, called Bonsi.
Now, this is a possible question because you come from a community.
I'm sure.
So go into those details, sir. Just figure that the Scheduled Caste and Scheduled Tribe all are available on the census. Go through the figure, and after knowing that this is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 tribes, and this is most numerous. This is the percentage of the total Scheduled Tribe population. Out of 8%, this is constituting this percent, this is constituting that percent. And what is the representation in service? That is also available. Based on that, you should come out with the answer ki how it can be done.
Indian Oil, you have worked for quite some time now, from not so senior position to sufficiently senior position today. There is a little hush-hush talk regarding privatization. Are you aware?
Yes, sir. BPCL is right now.
So, what can you talk about that? The pros and cons and your perspective?
Sir, I think the government should first of all make very comprehensive policy regarding disinvestment, because ad hoc policies sometimes create some issues regarding. Right now, like, nobody is coming to purchase BPCL, and like Air India. So, they should make very good comprehensive policy and long term policy. So, like, market players can understand that their government have some very good policy. Yes, at that time we can enter in this sector. So, first of all, thing is that. So, disinvestment is no doubt a good good regarding to gain some financial support, and also it provide a public investment opportunities, and also it create efficiency and competition when you are entering in market, but as oil sector is a strategic sector, definitely. So it is better the government should not disinvest Indian Oil, because Indian Oil is a major share in market in India. So we should make that.
But you said that they should make a long term policy in a sector which is a depleting sector, even by an inch. Can you really make a long term? So, completely fluid.
Yes, sir. Like right now, like government is coming out from steel. Earlier, they invested in as per industrial policy, policy resolution 1956. They invest heavily in steel sector because at that time the private sector is not there. So that time we invest heavily. But in 1980s, he promoted lot of just Jindal Steel, Tata Steels are coming. So it create competition and it create very good opportunity for improving infrastructure of India. So that same kind of position that, like right now Indian oil, yes, oil sector is depleting, but we need to improve, we need to provide public investment for electrical vehicles, electrical research. So we need that kind of solution. That's okay. After that 2030.
But sorry for interjection. Yeah. You started your answer with saying that we have an ad hoc policy regarding disinvestment. How you can justify this?
Sir, 14th Finance Commission clear cut mentioned that the government's disinvestment policy sometimes create could not attract lot of buyers, very good buyers, and so it increased the losses of government. So definitely a very good policy regarding disinvestment, a complete long term policy, because like right now the Air India, the same things, like yes, after 2030 the government is planning that right now oil is depleting. We need to, after 2020, we need electrical vehicles, so some kind of startups and after 2020 we have planned that Indian Oil is disinvested. So there is a lot of fraternity can improve regarding electrical vehicles. These kind of policy is required, sir.
Okay. Tell me, you are a keen sportsman, it seems.
Yes, sir.
And that's really heartening. Your being a good sportsman, and tomorrow you will be a civil servant, senior civil servant. Correlation?
Yes, sir. Right now, one of my friend in Odisha is IAS, and right now he is handling the sports development development authority, some kind of authority to improve sports. That definitely, as a sportsperson, I can improve a lot. Right now, there is a lot of demands that sportsperson should have some share in sports governance. So definitely, as a sportsperson, and I understand better in terms of sportsmanship.
But you are joining a lot of journalists, and they say that journalists have spoiled our sector because they don't understand the nuances. You may be an exception.
Sir, I'm
just trying to provoke you.
I can provide a domain. I can achieve domain expertise in sports if I get opportunity.
Mountaineering course you have done.
Yes, sir.
Tell us something about that.
Sir, in mountaineering course, first of all, they provide to understand the...
Which course is this?
So, basic mountaineering course.
In Oli?
In Manali, sir.
Manali. Okay.
Manali. So, it provides opportunities to learn about mountaineering equipments, which is used like ice axe and sleeping kit and all these things.
You have undertaken some...
Okay. Forget it. Any example of delegated legislation?
So delegated legislation like environmental protection?
Any example I'm asking.
Any example?
Specific example of delegated legislation.
You are talking about, sir, rules and regulation, or are you talking... Like income tax officers are getting delegation from income tax.
And what are they doing? What are they supposed to do under the delegated legislation?
Sir, they work regarding to implement income tax, like punishment. Like suppose income tax rules in act is passed, and then after they provide the like punishment, capturing of to catch criminals and all.
But that's already provided under the act. How do they legislate?
So they make some procedures and process regarding the same.
Okay.
Okay, you were from Nasirabad.
Yes, sir.
Studied there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so just tell me, what is this Nasirabad? What kind of governance Nasirabad has?
Sir, Cantonment Board, sir.
Cantonment Board.
Yes, sir.
What is it? Can you define a little bit?
Sir, Cantonment Board is the a board which have elected member, also member from military, elected member as well as defense person also, nominated defense person. This is governed by Ministry of Defence.
Okay, you are working in ISCL. Before that, you were in IIT Powai.
Yes, sir.
You have gone for any industry visit to a major industry there, which of very strategic importance to India, very close to you in Powai, 10 kilometers. IIT Mumbai would have taken you for a visit to a strategic.
Sir, actually, we went to Mahindra manufacturing plant in Pune.
I don't think that is for strategic. 10 kilometers.
Atomic energy.
To BARC.
BARC, yes, sir. Sorry. BARC, sir.
Have you visited?
No, sir.
Okay. But then I think.
I didn't get a chance.
I'm sure you should have answered this. Anyway,
sorry, sir.
Last point from my side. You have been in ISUL for a long time and risen from manager to, I mean, from a younger level to manager level, and must have gone to more, other than mechanical side, you would have been visionary by now in managing capacity. So can you tell us quickly about oil security concerns of India? How much we produce and how it is urgent?
So right now we are producing only 33 million metric ton per year, and right now we are processing 249 million metric ton, which is majorly come from outside. So definitely we need to diversify our sources, and also we need to look into LNG, CNG, shale gas kind of sector also, because right now like ONGC is doing lot of research on shale gas, and we are trying to produce, but however we could not achieve so much commercial viability. So one thing is that, and also like in energy sector we also can develop renewable sources to curb the oil import, and also we increase energy efficiency and increase lot of rules and regulation to improve energy security.
What are those renewable sources for energy sector?
Solar energy, wind energy, Delhi Shakti.
What about ethanol?
Yes, sir. The government, as per national biofuel policy, government has provided that up to by 2030 we have to blend to 20% of ethanol in petrol and diesel.
So is it this policy is effective one?
Sir, definitely.
Right now, what is the percentage of?
Right now we are 10%, sir.
10%. We have achieved 10%, or we are yet to achieve?
Sir, by 2020 it is a target, so definitely we have to achieve.
We have not achieved as yet 10%.
Sir, right now.
Which is the country foremost in this aspect, ethanol?
Sir, Brazil.
How much percentage they have achieved?
I am exactly not sure, but I think 20%, sir.
Okay. Sorry.
Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Can you name the administrative ministry of IOCL?
Ministry of PNG, sir. Petroleum Natural Gas.
Presently, where is the father posted?
Sir, in Bareilly.
In Bareilly.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.